dear students, we are generally under the impression that we only need oxygen to live. You are wrong if you also think in the same way. Some other elements such as carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, phosphorus, and sulfur are also equally important. Today we will discuss about the role of nitrogen and its recycling in our ecosystem. Nitrogen is one of the most important elements in our planet. Its symbol is capital N, atomic number is 7, and has 3 unpaired electrons in its second shell. Nitrogen is the most abundant element in its gaseous phase. It forms 78% of the air by volume. However, this most abundant gas is not available to the living organisms. Why is it so? I will answer this question at the end of this lecture. So keep watching this video till end to understand the fate of nitrogen in our ecosystem. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel Biology for All. Nitrogen is fixed both abiotically and biotically. Abiotic fixation of nitrogen occurs during thunderstorms and through the industrial processes to form nitrogen fertilizers. Living organisms also fix atmospheric nitrogen. Some of these organisms live independently, while others have developed symbiotic association with other organisms. Lightning accounts for some naturally occurring reactive nitrogen. Worldwide, each year, lightning fixes an estimated 3 to 10 teragrams of nitrogen. The energy that lightning generates converts oxygen and nitrogen to nitric oxide, which oxidizes to nitrogen dioxide, then to nitric acid. Within days, the nitric acid is carried to the ground in rain, snow, hail, and other atmospheric depositions. This source of reactive nitrogen is important to areas in which nitrogen fixing plants are scarce. Two German scientists, Fritz Haber and Karl Bosch, developed an artificial way to convert non-reactive atmospheric nitrogen to ammonia. Ammonia is the reactive compound that forms the base of nitrogen fertilizers. Currently, the Haber-Bosch process is used to produce about 170 teragrams of reactive nitrogen per year worldwide, most of which is used to produce nitrogen fertilizers. Food grown with this fertilizer feeds some 2 billion people around the world. The global use of nitrogen fertilizers is increasing by about 15 teragrams per year. The free-living nitrogen-fixing organisms are called asymbiotic organisms. Soil-dwelling aerobic and anaerobic saprobic bacteria fix nitrogen to ammonia. These soils must have good supply of organic manure. The Clostridium is an example of anaerobic bacteria, while Azotobacter represents aerobic bacteria. Blue-green algae are another type of autotrophic photosynthetic organisms. These grow in waterlogged and wet soils like paddy rice fields. Blue-green algae of families Nostoceles are important member of autotrophic nitrogen-fixing organisms. Anabina is an important member of this group. It consists of branched filaments. These filaments are made up of two types of cells. Green photosynthetic cells fix the atmospheric carbon dioxide and release oxygen during photosynthesis. The slightly enlarged, colorless and non-photosynthetic cells called heterocysts fix atmospheric nitrogen aerobically. Lichens, another group of autotrophic nitrogen fixing groups are the examples of mycophycophyta, where algae and fungi coexist, benefiting each other. The algal components fix the molecular nitrogen in the form of organic compounds. Symbiotic nitrogen fixation is the most important process of nitrogen fixation. Nodule-forming rhizobium species have developed symbiotic relationship with many leguminous plants like bean, pea, gram, and soybean. Leguminous plants increase the soil fertility. Similarly, several species of fungi belonging to the group actinomycetes have developed mycorrhizal association with the roots of pinus and other plants and fix atmospheric nitrogen. All the aforementioned processes fix non-reactive nitrogen to ammonia that can be taken up directly by the plants through their roots. However, most of the ammonia produced by decay is converted into nitrates. Conversion of ammonia to nitrates is accomplished in two steps. Bacteria of genus Nitrosomonas oxidize ammonia to nitrites, while bacteria of genus Nitrobacter oxidize the nitrites to nitrates. These two groups of autotrophic bacteria are called nitrifying bacteria. Through their metabolic activities, these bacteria make nitrogen available to the plant roots. However, in 2015, it was found that bacteria in the genus Nitrospira were able to convert ammonia to nitrites and nitrites to nitrates single-handedly. This ability is called COMAMOX for complete ammonium oxidation. Denitrification is the reversal of nitrification. In this process, nitrates are converted to nitrites and nitrites to nitrogen gas. Bacteria that carry out this process are named as denitrifying bacteria. Denitrification removes nitrogen from the atmosphere and passes it out of the living systems. Several intermediate nitrogenous compounds such as nitric oxide, nitrous oxide, which is a powerful greenhouse gas and 300 times as potent as carbon dioxide, and nitrous oxide are formed during this process. Denitrifying bacteria live deep in soil and in aquatic sediments where conditions are anaerobic. They use nitrates as an alternative to oxygen for final electron acceptor in their respiration. Anammox or anaerobic ammonia oxidation is a process whereby anaerobic bacteria living deep in marine and freshwater sediments are able to oxidize ammonia, forming nitrogen gas. The anammox reactions may account for as much as 50% of the denitrification occurring in the oceans. All these processes participate in closing the nitrogen cycle. This is a diagrammatic representation of nitrogen cycle, which shows how nitrogen moves between living and non-living systems. This ends up our lecture. I have a little question for you today. According to the molecular theory of gases, the gases with higher partial pressure have higher solubility in liquids. Thus, nitrogen, being 78% by volume in air, has higher partial pressure than oxygen. Despite its higher partial pressure, nitrogen does not dissolve in our blood on inhalation. Why? Can you explain the reason? If you have the answer to this question, you can write it in the comment section and I will see how good is your answer. Bye for now. Thank you.